Hey, Victory Kids! It's Miss Cheryl here at the church for our last How to Train Your Attitude lesson. I know you guys have been busy with your online learning at home, and I'm really, really happy that this week is spring break, so you should be able to get a little break from all that classroom learning that you're doing at home. So even though you can't probably go anywhere for spring break, you're going to be staying at home, at least you can enjoy some adventures maybe in your backyard, or try to use your imaginations and go some places in your mind that are fun. So I hope that you have a great spring break. And Easter is next Sunday, so we're super excited about that. We'll be bringing you a cool lesson from the church, maybe somewhere outside. So we're happy to do that for you. So just tune in, and so this is our last lesson. I hope you enjoy it. So let's start with a word of prayer, okay? Father, thank you so much for these boys and girls that are listening, and I pray that they would sit up and listen now and pay attention, that you would help them to learn something important today from your word. It's so important that we stop and we read your word and we listen for your voice, and I pray, God, that these boys and girls would do that today. We love you and hope you have a great day. I pray for our country, that you would protect it and that you would heal the land in Jesus' name. Amen. So in How to Train Your Attitude, the first movie, the dragons start out being very scary. They are mean, they are hunted, they are killed because they're mean to the humans, until Hiccup comes along and he decides that he's going to treat these dragons differently. He's going to be kind to them. He's going to be nice to them. He's going to end up loving them, and in turn he's teaching them to obey him. And the dragons, you'll learn that they want to obey because Hiccup is being kind. So this series we've talked about some ways to train your attitude, and just like Hiccup trained Toothless, God can train us through his word, and his word is the Bible. So we're going to be talking about that today, but let's just review some of the lessons that we learned this series. So we've learned to control our tongue, which is very hard to do sometimes. We've learned, instead of tearing down, that we need to build each other up. We've also learned to have a grateful heart, that please and thank you should always go together, just like peanut butter and jelly. We've also learned to have compassion. We learned last week about a man who had compassion on someone who had been beaten. And compassion is showing love in action, not just saying that we love because God loves us, but we love and we're here to help, and that's compassion. So today we're going to learn about something else. We're going to learn about obedience. And just like Hiccup trained Toothless to obey him, with love, God wants us to obey him with love. So we're going to talk about that today. In the Old Testament, God chose a group of people to be his people, and we call those people the Israelites. We get that from the Bible. So our story today comes from the book of Joshua. It is a book of history. If you remember, we studied all the different books that are in the Old Testament, and Joshua is the book of history. So the Israelites were God's chosen people, and they were in bondage in Egypt. They were slaves to the Egyptians. They had to work for very little food. And one day God said that enough was enough, and that his people were going to be set free. So in a series of miracles, God moved them out of Egypt into the wilderness, where they were going to go to the promised land, the land of Canaan. In the wilderness, God gave his chosen people some rules to follow, and those rules are called the Ten Commandments. The Ten Commandments was a set of rules that the children of Israel would go by, and as long as they obeyed God's rules, they would be protected and cared for, and they would be blessed. One of the Israelites' greatest leaders was a man named Joshua, and Joshua was chosen by God to lead the children of Israel into the promised land. The promised land was the land of Canaan. It had good soil. It was going to produce good crops for the children of Israel. They would have plenty to eat. They would be provided for and protected there. And God wanted them to obey these rules in order to receive the blessings of God. So Joshua, right before he died, he was giving them this powerful speech. And all the children of Israel were there, and he's standing up, and they didn't have a microphone, so he must have been saying it so loudly for everyone to hear. And he said this amazing speech, and he reminded the children of Israel to obey God's rules. He reminded them not to turn to the other gods that they might find in the land. He reminded them to love God and to serve God so that they could have continued blessings and they could have continued peace and provision. That means God would give them what they needed. I'm going to read you part of this really cool speech found in Joshua chapter 24 and verse 15. And it says this: "Choose you this day whom ye will serve. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." Joshua wanted the people to make a choice. Who were they going to obey? Were they going to follow God's rules and obey God and continue to receive the blessings? Or were they going to do it their own way and not have the protection and the blessings of God? So we find out later that the children of Israel obeyed. Initially, they were very obedient, boys and girls, but they listened to Joshua that day. They followed Joshua's leadership and they listened. Who are you listening to? Is there an influencer out there or a YouTuber? Is there maybe a movie star or a singer? Maybe your favorite pop star or country music artist? Maybe they've got your ear. Maybe you're listening to them instead of listening to God. Boys and girls, we need to put all of those other voices aside, and we need to listen to God. We do that by staying in the Word of God. That's why we want you to learn your Bible verses. That's why at Awana we push you to learn verses so that you can stay in tune with God's voice. Did you know when your Bible is open, God is speaking? This is God's Word. And He will speak to you in a still, small voice. It's not loud like influencers. And it's not loud like YouTubers. And it's not loud like pop stars. It's a soft voice that God speaks with. So you have to be still and you have to be quiet and talk to Him, and He'll talk to you back. And He will show you the way to go. He'll show you the rules to obey. When we follow God's rules found in God's Word, we will be successful. We will be blessed. We'll have God's protection, and He'll provide for us, because when we obey, we show that we love God. Just like the dragons obeyed because they loved the Vikings. When we obey, we show we love God, and God will bless us. Now, I brought some Lego sets here to show you how important it is to follow the rules. I gave Parker two Lego sets. So they look like this. I hope you can see it. It's a little monster truck. And I told Parker, I want you to put together this Lego set, and I don't want you to use the instructions. Do the best you can, but don't follow the rules of the Lego set. Just do it however you want to do it. And this is how he built it. And it looks okay. It's missing a wheel and a tire. I'm not sure where those went off to. And it still rolls pretty good. Can you see that? It rolls. But the second Lego set, I said, now Parker, I want you to follow the rules. I want you to follow the instructions. And it takes you step by step on how to build this Lego truck. And here is the finished product. Now this one looks good, right? It looks like the person knew what they were doing, and it looks amazing, just like the box and the instructions say to do. Did you know, just like the Legos have an instruction book, you have an instruction book too. How to live your life, and this is your instruction book. God's Word, the Word of God, shows us how to live, our lives every day. Every answer is in this book. Now let me tell you something. Do you want to look like this, do it your own way? Or do you want to look like this, doing it God's way? I want to look like this. I hope you do too. Let's remember, let's not do it ourselves. Let's obey the rules of God, and those are found in God's Word. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for the Word of God, for giving us an instruction book on how to live our lives. Help us to obey this week and every week the rules in your Word. Help us to obey our mom and dad, our grandmas and grandpas, whoever's in authority over us. Please help us obey. In Jesus' name, amen. Join us next week as we start our Easter lesson, and then we'll go into a brand new series. Hope to see you then. Bye, guys.